गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वी आर वंस अगेन बैक इन द सेम चैप्टर दैट इज सॉलिड स्टेट. इन दिस चैप्टर, इन टुडेज टॉपिक, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट क्रिस्टल डिफेक्ट. नाउ व्हाट एक्चुअली आर क्रिस्टल डिफेक्ट? क्रिस्टल डिफेक्ट्स आर बेसिकली इरेगुलरिटीज इन द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट पार्टिकल्स. If the normal arrangement of particles is there, then the crystal is a regular one. But if this arrangement differs, if there are certain problems, if there are certain dissimilarities, if there are certain differences in the arrangement, then only the crystal defects they arises. Now, crystal defects are of two types, that is point defect and line defect. In case of point defect, now what we know that if there are certain variations in the crystals, if there are certain variations in case of point defect, we know that if these defects are in the irregularities or deviations from the ideal arrangement around a point or an atom in a crystal, then this is called a point defect. In point defect, as we know, that point defects are the irregularities or deviations from the ideal arrangement. Irregularities in the deviations from the ideal arrangement that actually causes this type of point defect. Okay, after that, next type of defect we have is the line defect. In case of line defect, now what we know, this line defect arises when there are irregularities or deviations from ideal arrangement in the entire row of the lattice crystal. In the entire row of the lattice crystal, there is deviations from the ideal arrangement. Now we are going to discuss the different types of defects. Different types of defects are of two types, that is, first of all, they are actually impurity defect, and the second one, we have different types of stoichiometric defects and for non-ionic solid. See, as you could see in this adjoining figure, we have a crystal of sodium and chloride. Now, in this case, see, each of the violet circle shows the sodium and the green circle shows the chlorine. So, here it is a regular arrangement, but here we could see that one of the sodium is being replaced by a strontium atom whose charge is plus 2. We could see that this strontium has a charge of plus 2. Here we have Cl. And here also we have the sodium, this chlorine, but here there is a vacancy or that of a gap. Now, what is this gap called? This gap is called as vacancy. In this gap, we could see that these metal ions are present. Okay. So, because see, when one of the sodium is replaced by strontium, but each of the strontium has a charge of plus 2. In order to maintain electrical neutrality, what we actually have, we have over here that this place where sodium should have been, one strontium is coming, but the charge of strontium is plus 2. Hence, there is the creation of a vacancy. This vacancy is called the vacant places caused because of this impurity defect. Because of the impurity defect, there is vacancy being created. In other parts, we see that there is the same chlorine and the same sodium present. So, electrically, we can say that the crystal is bearing the same charge because one sodium replaced by one strontium. So, the extra strontium positive point is there, and because of which there is a vacancy, and this vacancy is called as the vacant place created. Okay, now another type of defect, as you could see over here, that here also we have two vacancies. Means it might be such that one of the vacancy is for the positive and other of the vacancy is for the negative ion. Now the next part we would be discussing is the interstitial. We were discussing about that of the interstitial defect. Now, what are interstitial defect? As we know, that interstitial defect is a defect in which we say that a crystal is said to have an interstitial defect when some of the constituent particles occupy an interstitial site. What is the meaning of interstitial site? It is not present in its own site, but it is occupying an intermediate site. This intermediate site is called the interstitial site. This defect results in the increase in the density of the substance. Why increase in density? See, as you could see, it is not occupying normal places, but is occupying in these intermediate places, which were actually the voids or the gaps, or they were the interstitial points. These were the voids, or these were the gaps, or these were the interstitial points. As a result, there is always an increase in the density of this substance. As a result, there is always an increase in the density of the substance. And that was about the interstitial defect or defect, which is because of the presence of various ions intermediate between that of its normal position. This is called as interstitial. After that, children, we are going to discuss about one important defect, that is under the stoichiometric defect, and that defect is called a Schottky defect. As you could see the adjoining figure, this is the diagram for those crystals which show this type of defect, which is called a Schottky defect. Now the question comes, what is a Schottky defect? This defect arises when, see, equal number of vacancies are there. See, equal number of cation, anion vacancies are there. As you could see here, it should have been a cation, but the cation is missing. In this third line, you could see there should have been anion, so the anion is missing. Here also you can see, here in this, there should be a anion, but anion is missing, and here it should be a cation, cation is missing. So if a crystal is such that it has equal numbers of cation, anion vacancies, then this type of defect is called as Schottky defect. So this defect arises when equal number of cations and equal number of cations and anions are missing. Okay, and also you should know, it is a common defect. It is a common defect and is observed. It is a common defect and it is observed when we see that compounds of high coordination number and also compounds which are highly crystalline in nature, that is where both the cations and anions are same in size. For example, in case of KCl, in case of NaCl, in case of NaBr. Okay, due to this defect, what will happen? Density of the crystal decreases and it begins to conduct electricity to a smaller extent. Why? Because see, electric conduction is because of the charge. But as there is a vacancy, charge separation is not there. What is causing a vacancy? Because of vacancy, what is happening? It is causing this type of defect. Okay, because of this, it is causing a type of defect. In this case also, we could see that this type of defect is there. There are also certain types of vacancies, and these vacancies are called as anion vacancies or cation vacancies. Because of anion cation vacancy, what we could see, that there is the creation of this type of defect. And this defect is called as Schottky defect. After that, we have Frenkel or dissociation defect. It is that type of defect in which we see. So as I have told you that in this type of defect, which is called as Frenkel defect or dislocation defect, in this defect, the smaller ions, usually cations, they dislocate from its normal place and they occupy those positions which are interstitial sites, which are actually intermediate position, and it creates a vacancy. It creates actually a vacancy, and this vacancy is created in such a way that because of this type of defect, what we observe generally, that the smaller ions they actually occupy interstitial site. It creates a vacancy defect at its original site and an interstitial defect at its new location. So it causes an interstitial defect at its new location because of the migration of the cations or the anions from its normal place to that of an interstitial place. As a result, what is happening? There is the creation of certain types of defects, or I should say there is the creation of certain types of intermediate sites are being located. Okay, that is, in this I can say that this defect arises when the original site is vacant but it occupies interstitial position. As a result, what is happening? Density does not vary. In the previous one, what we saw, that the density was changing, but in this case density does not change. Why? Because number of ions are same, but the problem is that instead of occupying its original place, it is occupying an interstitial position. Okay, that's why this type of defects, which are called as Frenkel or dislocation defect, arises. Okay, these are generally found in crystals like zinc sulfide, silver chloride, AgBr, AgI. Okay, they are found in crystals like zinc sulfide, AgCl, AgBr, and AgI. Okay. These are these type of defects which are called as Frenkel or dislocation defect. After that, we have different types of non-stoichiometric defect. After that, we will discuss about different types of non-stoichiometric defect. Now, in this non-stoichiometric defect, what we see that as you could see that here it actually changes the stoichiometry of a compound. Now, what is called stoichiometry? Now, stoichiometry means actually the change in its ratio. So as you could see in the adjoining diagram, that is, this type of non-stoichiometric defects are there. They are of actually metal deficiency defect, and which actually changes the stoichiometry or the simple ratio of the cations and the anions. They are of two types, that is metal excess defect and metal deficiency defect. In case of metal deficiency, as you could see in the figure, that the metal which has would have been present over there, here actually what is happening, instead of the positive metal, there is an electron present. So as the electron is present, it is causing this type of metal excess defect. Now in metal deficiency defect, what we see, this defect arises because of the absence of metal ion sites. The electrical neutrality, neutrality is maintained by its adjunction having a charge. Reason for the cause of metal excess defect. What are the reasons for the causes of metal excess defect? It arises because of two factors. Now, one is called anionic vacancies. Next is the presence of extra cation. What is the meaning of anionic vacancies? A compound may have an extra metal ion if there is absence of its lattice site. See, in the case of anionic vacancies, now what we see, the compound may have an extra metal ion. It may have an extra metal ion if the negative ion is absent from its lattice site. If the negative ion is absent from its lattice site, obviously cations will become much more, anions will become less. This empty lattice site is called a hole. To maintain electrical neutrality, the site is occupied by an electron. In order to maintain electrical neutrality, the site is occupied by an electron. The hole occupied by an electron is called epicenter, or that has another name, that is called Farben's center. That is called Farben's center. The epicenter is responsible for the color of the compound. So this, the presence of epicenter is responsible for the color of the compound. If larger number of epicels are there, the compound becomes much more colorful. Next, we have presence of extra cation. A compound is said to have an extra cation if a cation is present in the interstitial site. If cation is present in the interstitial site and electron is present in the interstitial site to maintain electrical neutrality. Electron is present in the interstitial site in order to maintain electrical neutrality. So these are the reasons for the cause of metal excess defect. Now we would be discussing the electrical properties of solids. After that, children, we are going to discuss the classification of the solids based on their electrical conductivities. Okay. So they are of three basic types, that is conductor, insulator, and semiconductor. In case of conductor, are the solids with conductivity ranging from this specific range, that is they allow electric current to pass through them. They are called as conductors. So conductors are those substances which allow electric current to pass through it. Okay, and their conductivity range is 10 to the power 7 ohm per meter. After that, we have the next one, that is insulators. Insulators are those solids which have very low conductivity values, and the value ranges from 10 to the power negative 10 to 10 to the power negative 20 ohm per meter. 10^-10 to 10^-20 ohm per meter. Now, causes of conductance in solid. What are the causes for the conduction in solid? In case of solids, now what we know that there are certain band theories. The band theories explain it, that is in case of conductor, the bands are overlapping, so they can easily allow electric current to pass. In case of semiconductor, the band is very less, the gap is very less. As a result, what happens? They allow some part of the current to pass through it. But in case of insulator, what is happening? The band is so big that it cannot cross that band. As it cannot cross that band, hence they become actually non-conductor. In case of insulators, the forbidden gap is very large and electrons are unable to excite to the conduction band. They cannot excite to that of the conduction band. In case of semiconductor, the forbidden gap is small. Therefore, some electrons may jump to conduction band and they can show some conductivity. Electrical conductivity of semiconductors increases with the rise in temperature, since more electron can jump to that of the conductivity band. Now we will discuss types of semiconductors. Now, semiconductors are of these specific types, that is intrinsic semiconductor, extrinsic semiconductor. In case of intrinsic semiconductor, what we see, these are those semiconductors in which the forbidden gap is small. Only some electrons may jump to the conduction band and show certain conductivity. They have very low electrical conductivity. For example, silicon and germanium. Extrinsic semiconductor, when an approximate impurity is added to an intrinsic semiconductor, is called extrinsic semiconductor. The electrical conductivity becomes high. Now, next thing we are going to discuss is doping. In case of doping, what we know, the process of adding an appropriate amount of suitable impurity. The process of adding an appropriate amount of suitable impurity to increase the conductivity of a semiconductor is known as doping. After that, we have two types, that is N-type and P-type semiconductor. In case of N-type semiconductors, they are formed. We have N-type semiconductor. They are found when the silicon is doped with electron-rich impurity like group 15 elements. The increase in conductivity is due to the negatively charged electron. Then we have P-type semiconductor. In a P-type semiconductor, now what we see, they are formed when the silicon is doped with electron deficient impurities like group 13 elements. The increase in conductivity is due to the positively charged holes. After that, we have types of extrinsic semiconductor diode. It is a combination of N-type and P-type semiconductor and is used in the rectifier. Okay. After that, next thing we have is transistors. They are made by sandwiching a layer of one type of semiconductor between two layers of the other type of semiconductor. The NPN and PNP. See, the N, then P, then N. Then after that, we have the P, then N, then P. So there are two types, NPN and PNP. Type of transistors are used to detect or amplify the radio or audio signals. Now what we know, that the 12-16 compound, these compounds are formed by the combination of the group 12 and the group 16 compounds. Group 12 and the group 16 compounds, they possess an average vacancy of 4, example zinc sulfide, cadmium sulfide and HGT, this type of alloys. After that, we have group 13 to group 15 compound. These compounds are formed by the combination of group 13 group 15 compound. They possesses an average valency of 4. Example is this. Okay, these are the ones, that is here we have INSB aluminium phosphide and germanium arsenide. Every substance has certain magnetic properties associated with it, and these magnetic properties are of two motions actually, its orbital motion around the nucleus and its spin around its own axis. These are the cases. In this we have these different types of compounds, that is paramagnetic, then we have paramagnetic, we have diamagnetic, we have ferromagnetic, we have antiferromagnetic, and we have ferrimagnetic. Now the question comes, that is based on its magnetic behavior, the compounds are of, first of all, paramagnetic. In case of paramagnetism, what we know, these are those substances which are weakly attracted to magnetic field due to the presence of unpaired electrons. In case of diamagnetic, what we see, these are those substances which are highly attracted to or repelled by extra magnetic field. Diamagnetism is shown by those substances in which all the electrons are paired. In case of ferrimagnetic substances, these are those substances which are attracted strongly by a magnetic field. Then the anti-ferrimagnetic substances, these have equal number of parallel and anti-parallel magnetic poles. These are examples of anti-ferromagnetic substances. Then we have ferrimagnetic substances. They have unequal number of parallel and anti-parallel magnetic fields. And as a result of which, what actually happens, that these type of substances which are ferrimagnetic is because of unequal number of magnetic moments of parallel anti-parallel directions, and as a result net magnetic moment is small. Example of this type of substance is Fe3O4, MgFe2O4. Okay, so these are about the five different types of magnetic properties we encounter. Okay children, that is all for the day. Thank you.